Hello and welcome back in this new episode of the Python Physics Engine series. In the last episode we have seen how to smash together particles. In this episode I'll try to explain how to simulate collision between particles and walls. First of all we must define the wall, and this is obtained by introducing the fixed surface class. This has a location defined by its start position and its end position. Both are point in the two-dimensional space. If we want, we can use the Pythagoras theorem to calculate the length of this surface, but it's not important for now. And then here there are three important quantities that we will use during the simulation of the collision. There is the angular coefficient of the segment, its quote, and the angle between the segment and the x-axis. How to calculate them? We can use the calculate MQ function that I define here. So to calculate the angular coefficient, what we can do is just make the ratio between the y part of two points on the segment, extrema of the segment will be perfect, and the x part of the same points. So this is very simple, and from the angular coefficient calculated the alpha will be even simpler because it requires only to apply the arctangent function. But also the quote is easy to calculate, just take some algebra and this is the resulting formula. But this has a problem. As you know, in math you can divide it by zero. Here we have a division and delta x can be zero. This is because we can describe a vertical line using the angular coefficient. What we can do is simple. We take this expression only if delta x is different from zero. Otherwise we will use a variable that we call x type that let us understand that we have a vertical line. So normally we don't have a vertical line and this variable will be true. But if we have a vertical line, this variable will become false, and in that case we already know what is the angle with the x-axis. It will be just pi divided by 2. So I create a surface array and then I draw them on screen. This is the result. Beautiful square! Okay, now let's calculate when an intersection takes place. So I must have an intersection function that takes in input the segment considered and all the particles. And then for every particle I must repeat this process. This will be for vertical segment and this will be for all the other segments. So what I've done is calculate the distance between the two points, and if the distance is less than a given variable, in that case 14, then I detect an intersection and return true. Otherwise, if no particle collide with anything, I return false. Pay attention that this intersection function detects only one collision per clock, but in future I will change this. Now that we have an intersection, what happens? We must use this scatter function. So there is this where variable that uses the previous function, the function that we just created to understand if there is an intersection. And if there is an intersection, I just apply this formula for the x direction and the y direction. Temp vx and temp vy are just temporal variable in order to write this formula properly, but this is the main formula. Let's think about a segment and a particle that goes to the segment. Then observe the same scenario with a different angle, and to rotate something you just use the complex notation and then multiply by the complex alpha of the rotation. From this observation point the particle just changes its perpendicular velocity, and so we must just change a sign, and then we must anti-rotate the system to return to the initial situation. And here I obtain the formula. Really spectacular. So I create 20 particles to fill in a random way the square. Inside the cycle function I detect the scatter and then I run the program. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Stay tuned for more videos.